Hi everyone, and welcome to the next video in this mini-series where I'll be teaching you how to run your Django Docker image, okay, within Amazon ECS, just as a simple, normal, containerized application. So very basic, very simple. We're not going to add anything fancy such as domain names, application load balancers, or anything like that. It's going to be very simple. So first of all, head over to Amazon ECR, Elastic Container Registry. And if you followed in my previous video, you will have noticed that we went ahead and pushed our Django Docker image to our Amazon ECR registry repository, like so. So what I suggest you do is just open another tab. So I'm going to open two here. Okay, and I'm going to open another one. So we have at least three tabs open. Now the first one will just be for Elastic Container Registry. And the next two we'll utilize for ECS and EC2. Okay, so now we want to run and transform this Docker image as a Docker container. So we want to go to ECS, Elastic Container Service. Okay, and the first thing we want to do is we want to specify a task definition. So this task definition is going to specify the details, okay, which will be based on our Docker image. So we are going to tell our Docker container, hey, okay, I want my specific task or Docker image to run in such a fashion. So head over to task definitions. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to delete this one I have here. So just give me a moment. So I just want to deregister this. So I just want to start from scratch so it's easier for you guys. Okay, so let's clear this up again, go back. Okay, so this is what you should see here. Okay, so it's nice and clean for you. So head over and click on Create New Task Definition. And we're going to use the normal EC2 version. So click on that. Then you want to go to the next step. Perfect. Now you can go ahead and fill in all of this out, such as the task definition name, task role, network mode, and all of this. But I've made it very simple for you via a JSON file here. So what I can show you here is my JSON document here. Okay, where I have written out this code for you. So we can see here we're stating the container definitions. So we're setting the name. Okay, so the name of our container will be my Django application. The image, okay, we're going to then go ahead and paste in our Docker image URL here. Then we're setting some memory, the CPU, making this essential, set to true. So essential, basically, we want everything to be, want it to be on the high priority. And then the network mode is going to be bridge. And under the family here, we specify that this task definition is going to be renamed to Django app task definition. All right. Now, bridge is the default that is used with Dockerization here. So if we scroll up here, we can see the default here is basically going to use Docker's default networking mode. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I will paste this in the, I will pin this under the script, I will pin this as a comment, okay? So just be wary of this, so check the comments for this pinned comment here. And this is really a good reference that you can use in the future as a good reference guide, like a handy guide, in case you want to quickly, deploy your Docker-based applications to Amazon ECS, so keep this handy. So I'm going to show you how to do it. So let's just copy, let's say configure via JSON first. Delete everything here. I'm going to open this. Copy and paste that there. And all we need to do here is you can go ahead and change your container name, okay, if you'd like. CPU and memory, you can change if you'd like, but let's just keep it there for now. Network mode bridge, that's the default, so just leave it as is. And family is basically your task definition name. Okay, so the only things you need to really, you should really change is the name, your image, and the family here, which is basically your task definition name. So what we can do is click on, go back to Amazon ECR, Elastic Container Registry, and you just want to copy this URI that you have here for your Docker image. Then you want to go back and just remove this. And within quotes, you can paste the following. Okay, remember you need to paste your own one based in your URI. And everything else is fine as is. You can manipulate these, as I said, and you can say save. Perfect. Now you won't see anything spectacularly happen, okay? As long as you save it, just trust in the process that it's been saved. Now you can go ahead and say create. There we go. So the task definition was created. And for me, it shows 6 because I've done this 6 times. So don't worry, it's going to show probably 1 for you since this is your first time. and we can see that that family key that we set, okay, the value is Django app task definition. So that is what we set down here as the task definition name. And the name, my Django application, if we scroll down, we'll see that our container name is my Django application. So this is some very fancy JSON. It helps us spare all the worries and details of configuring all these settings in a weird archaic way. Okay, that's good. So we can now go to our cluster. Okay, and let's go ahead and create our cluster. So we can say create cluster. And we're going to make this based on EC2. So we're going to have an EC2 instance generated. You can go to the next step. Create your cluster. So here I'm just going to call this my cluster. Okay, select on demand. And under EC2 instance type, okay, be very careful with what you select here. So I'm going to choose, let's see if I can find it. I'm looking for the best here. That's T3 micro will do the job. So this will depend on how big your application is. For the one we have, this will be perfect. So just be wary and check the EC2 pricing. So what you can do is just give look at Google and just type in EC2 pricing AWS, check for the documentation, and then it will give you some information on the pricing. Actually, what I think I'm going to do to make it easier for you guys, I will put a link in the description describing the pricing here so you're not left in the dark. So just check that out, the description and the pinned comment that I'll put on for this specific JSON. So just be wary of that. One instance is fine. Okay, EC2, we're using the Amazon Linux 2 AMI. So this is our base OS image. Okay, the root EBS is fine. You can specify a key pair if you'd like. There's no need really. Okay, this is important. So under networking, we're going to use the default VPC that AWS provides us. And under subnets, it's best to select all the subnets and make sure you do it in alphabetical order. So what I mean by that is, for example, we have 2A, 2B, and 2C. Make sure you put it in alphabetical order. So here, 2A, then 2B, then 2C. Perfect. Now it says auto assign public IP. We want to say enabled because we're just going to connect to a normal IP. Security group, we want to create a security group because we want to modify this. Okay, we can leave the inbound rules. We will edit that soon enough. And what you can do is say create. Okay, so let's just wait for this to create. So basically what's going to happen now is just going to create our cluster. It's also going to attach an instance IAM policy to give ECS IAM roles and permissions. And of course, CloudFormation is going to create a stack, okay, which will consist of security groups, our EC2 instances, and that EC2 instance will be based on a T3 micro. Okay, perfect. So everything was completed. We can go to view our cluster. And there we go. So our cluster is now active, as we can see, and this is great. Now, what I want us to do before we actually create our service is go to Amazon EC2. So make sure you're in another tab. Okay, and what we want to do is we want to actually go ahead and just edit a few things regarding our security group. So head over to security groups. Okay, just open up the one that says EC2 container service my cluster, ECS security group. And what you want to do here is you just want to open this. Okay, there we go, perfect. Okay, so leave this open. We will return to it. Now, the next thing that we're going to do is we want to go back to our task definition. And the reason I'm doing this now, okay, let's just open this first. So click on your task definition. And what you want to do is you want to revise this task definition. So just say create new revision. Okay, and you can just say EC2. Everything else is already set as it was earlier on. And what I want you to do is just change one setting here. Now, the reason I'm explaining this now and not earlier on is because I want to explain this security group inbound rule. So what I want us to do is click on this container. Okay. Scroll down and I want you under port mappings to add a port mapping. Okay, so if we had an application load balancer, we technically could just set the host port to 0 and we can have dynamic host porting, but we're doing this with without application load balancer. So we need to add port mapping as well. Now, what I could have done is added port mapping in this JSON definition, but the reason I'm not doing it here is because I want you to understand the concept here, which I think will be better with what we're about to do with security groups. So make sure you go to port mapping. And remember, if you were following my previous videos, guys, I did set our port to be exposed at port 8000. Okay, so for that reason, we're just going to set the host port and the container port to port 8000. Okay, so just be wary of that. Okay, so you need to remember to add this, very important. Okay, so be sure to just add a revision to your container and just add these port mappings, or else you won't be able to actually connect to your application. So just be sure to add this as well. Okay, very important. Now what you can do is you can just simply say update. Okay, this is fine. And we want to say create. And now we will see a latest revision. So technically in your case, if you're following along, you will have two task revisions now. Now the second one, okay, is updated with our ports that are being mapped. So we want to map to our port to the specific container. Great. So now what we want to do is edit our inbound rules in our security groups here. So we can say edit inbound rules. Okay, you can leave the one here by default, but it's not really going to make much difference. And we want to add two new rules, okay, that are based on custom TCP. And our port, as you know, is 8000. That's what we just set now. So we want to set these ports. And under the source here, we're going to allow all IPv4 addresses to connect to our application. And all IPv6 addresses, which is denoted here, to our application. So make sure you add the following according to the port. That's what we just set now in our task definition. And you want to save the rules. Perfect. Now what we can do is we can now head over to clusters. Okay, we now can click on my cluster. And we want to now create a service, which is going to be based on the task definition and the number of tasks. So we can say create. Okay, we're using the EC2 launch type. We want to use the latest revision where we added our port mapping. Choose a service name. So I'm going to call this my service. Number of tasks, I would recommend setting it to 1. Okay, everything else can be as is. Okay, that's fine. You can leave everything as is and go to the next step. Okay, just scroll up. Okay, everything else here is fine. Now it's a whole nother ball game if you want to add a load balancer. There's quite a few things you need to configure, but we're going to keep it simple. So go to the next step. Okay, you can technically add auto scaling if you would like, if you want to scale your application, but I want to keep it simple. So let's go to the next step. Just review everything here. Make sure you have your latest task definition. Just check your service name. I would suggest only running one task for now, okay? If you plan on running more tasks, there's just something I'm going to mention at the video to help you with that. So let's just create the service. Okay, that's looking fine. View service. Let's refresh. Okay, there we go. So our task is pending. So what I would suggest that you guys do is just wait for a bit. So it won't take long until it starts running. It'll probably take about a minute or so before it says running. But what I would suggest that you do is once it says running, that you give it about 5 minutes, okay? Just to let everything propagate and just pin properly. So we can see it's running now. So what I'm going to do is wait for about 5 minutes or so, just so everything gets is running properly and there's no errors or anything like that before we actually check this out. So do be aware of your task. If for some reason this task changes, okay, that means there was an error in our deployment, but at the moment it looks good. So I'm gonna pause the video and wait a few minutes so you guys can wait as well. And then we're going to check and see if it works. All right, so let's just wait for everything to set up properly. Right, and welcome back. So I did wait a little bit overkill because I wanted to make sure everything's running okay for you guys. So what you can do now is you can head over and click on your task. Scroll down and you'll see your containers here and a drop down. So click on this drop down here and you'll see an external link here, which you can open up. So open that up. Okay, just wait for it to connect. Okay, just wait for this. Yeah, let's try this again. Okay, there we go. So that's it, guys. So as you can see here, we are now connected to our application via Amazon ECS. So we only connected via this IPv4 address that we see here that's being mapped to port 8000. Now, do bear in mind, if you're using application load balancer, okay, you will have dynamic mapping. So do bear that in mind. Okay, so for those of you, like I said earlier on, if you're planning on running more than one task, as you can see here, okay, you're going to have to make quite big changes to your application code. So I'll at least give you some direction into solving that. So basically, you would need to take a look at a package. So you can say PYPI, and it will be called CiderNet, I believe. This is it. So Django allow Cider. I'll also add this in the description. So this is some middleware that we are going to need to use, because what can happen is if you redeploy your task, for example, okay, it's going to be assigned a new IPv4 address. So we can see the IPv4 address that is set for this particular task here. So if we click on this task here and we go down here, we can see that it's our port is binded to the IPv4 address 3.17.27.36. Now, this is dynamic and this can change, especially if you're working with the application load balancer. So what you'll need to do is you'll need to have a look at this package here and install it, which is going to help you validate your CIDR ranges. So you can read more about this and take a look. Okay, so this will give you further guidance on how to actually ensure that no matter what happens, that you don't have any issues loading up your task here. Okay, so it is a bit of work to look into, but I just wanted to give you the basics so you at least have some understanding and direction where to go. So yeah, that's it, guys. So what I'll remember to do is I'm going to remember to put this in the chat here for you, the JSON here. Do remember that you also that you after you've added this, you need to redefine your task definition, okay, and add your port mappings in. Okay, technically I could have gone ahead and added the port mappings here in this definition, but what I wanted to do was to explain it in a better way to make it more understandable to you guys. That's just the way I think it should be done. So yeah, and then I'll also be sure to add in this, the description, this link here, and also I said I'll also add in, yeah, the pricing for EC2, so you can at least see how much it costs. So I don't want you guys to actually have this running for too long, because it can cost you money. So my suggestion, immediately after you're done, okay, just make sure that you head over to services here. Okay, click on your service and just delete it. So you can say delete me. So go ahead and do that. Done. Okay, head over to your tasks. So I want to close this. And you just want to click on the task and say stop. Okay, make sure it says stop. Great. Now go to your task definition. Go ahead and delete. Actually, to delete it, you must go in it. Delete all the revisions. Deregister it. Good. Okay. Good, it's not here. Now go ahead and delete your cluster itself. Okay, and delete cluster. Say delete me. And do that. Okay, so what's going to happen is basically the cluster is going to delete all the resources. So that includes, I believe, the security groups. But don't worry, security groups don't cost you money. But it will for sure delete your instance. It's going to delete anything else that is underlying in this cluster. So anything that was created, EC2, our EC2 instance, and all the resources aligned with it will be deleted if you delete the cluster. Make sure you delete everything else first that I showed you, such as the services, you stopped your tasks, you deleted your task definition, then only come and delete the cluster. Make sure you do it in this way, because sometimes there's a bit of a problem. Okay, so that's it, guys. So this will be deleted on its own, so you don't need to worry about that. So yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. So I hope this was helpful to you and gave you a basic understanding of how you can actually sort of, you know, run your Docker container in Amazon ECS. Okay, so that's it, guys. Thank you very much.